With data integration, you can load general ledger and subledger balances, reconciliation compliance transactions, transaction matching transactions for any data source. Load bank statements with built-in adapters for BAI, Swift MT 940, and KempT 053 formats. Data integration can also extract journal entries from transaction matching to post to the general ledger. Data integration allows you to load data from a text file, another cloud application, for example, Oracle ERP Cloud or NetSuite, an on-premise application using the EPM integration agent. To learn more about data loads from various sources, watch our videos linked in the description. Data integration provides more flexibility where special processing is required to load bank transactions or other types of complex files. With data integration, your files can be position dependent or in a delimited format. You can also map and transform data before loading it. Category mappings represent currency buckets in the form of entered, functional, or reporting. Category mapping applies to reconciliation compliance balances load, bank balance load, reconciliation compliance transaction load. Note that category mapping is not applicable for transaction matching transactions. Although category mapping is not applicable to transactions matching transactions, Oracle recommends using the category that aligns with the lowest enabled currency bucket on your transaction matching profiles. When setting up period mappings, keep in mind, application level mappings apply only to reconciliation compliance balances. Global mappings apply to reconciliation compliance transactions. Period mappings do not apply to transaction matching transactions because the transactions are period agnostic. When you load transaction matching transactions, Oracle recommends that you use the period that is most appropriate for each load. For reconciliation compliance transactions and transaction matching transactions, the data is pushed into the target application, just like other EPM cloud business processes like planning, financial consolidation, and close. The data integration process has three phases: import, validate, and export. This pushes the data from the workbench to the target application. For reconciliation compliance transactions, the import format should be configured for all data type instead of numeric data.
While mapping members, add a mapping for the data dimension to a text field.
For example, BEX for balance explanation, ADJ for adjustments, etc. These text values are not exported to the target, but the mapping is required. Transaction matching data sources can be added as target applications within data integration.
They appear with the notation match type colon data source along with an optional prefix.
After you create the target application, adding new data source members for transaction matching will break the connection with data integration. All transaction matching attributes are created with a dimension classification of ATTR or attribute.
Member mapping is not required for attribute dimensions. Therefore, this is more effective for most of the attributes. For attributes that require transformation, choose generic from the dimension classification dropdown and choose one of the UD columns data table column name. UD stands for user defined.
Unlike reconciliation compliance transactions and transaction matching transactions, for reconciliation compliance balances, loading is a data pull rather than a data push. You trigger a balance load for account reconciliation from the periods card. Select period, click the action button, and select import data.
Click the new button to create a new data load execution or choose one from already pre-configured data loads.
The load goes through three stages: staging, data load, post-process. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.